So you see, people, Christ is telling you, I am confusing them so that they won't turn back, so that they won't be forgiven. People, Mark chapter 4, verse 9. And he said to them, he who has ear to hear, let him hear. But when he was alone, those around him with the 12 asked him about the parable. And he said to them, to you it has been given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God. But to those who are outside, all things come in parable. So that seeing they may see and not perceive, and hearing they may hear and not understood, lest they should turn and their sins be forgiven them. He don't want the people to know, so that they will be sinners. Okay? And then, now Mark chapter 4, go to verse 34, and you see. But without a parable, he did not speak to them. And when they were alone, he explained all things to his disciples. So you see, people, Mark chapter 4, verse 34, is telling you Christ didn't even speak to the people without a parable. But when he was alone with his disciples, he explained all things to them. Oh my God, and people, why? So that in these people, the prophecy of Isaiah may be fulfilled. People, did any one of you ever check what the prophecy of Isaiah is? You all better check it. You all better check what the prophecy of Isaiah is, because Christ said in Matthew, he said, so that in these, the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled. What is the prophecy of Isaiah, people? Isaiah chapter 6. Wow. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. Okay? And also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? People, hold on. Isaiah, there's four Isaiahs, okay? Four different authors wrote the book of Isaiah. Not one. Four different authors. You could tell just by the writing, okay? I'll explain some other time. So, there's an evil Isaiah and there's a good one. That I know, but there's four of them, okay? Anyway, Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. This is Jesus Christ. Okay? Jesus Christ is one of the Isaiahs. And also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. And he said, go and tell these people, keep on seeing, but do not understand. Keep on seeing, but do not perceive. Make the heart of these people dull, and their ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their heart. Lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and return and be healed. So you see, people, Isaiah chapter 6, that's the prophecy that remember Christ said, so that in them the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled. There's more than one Isaiah in Isaiah. There's four of them who wrote this Bible. One of them is Jesus Christ. And here you go again. I'm reading to you again. Isaiah chapter 8, chapter 6, verse 8. Also I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. And he said, go and tell these people, keep on hearing, but do not understand. Keep on seeing, but do not perceive. Make the heart of these people dull, and their ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and return and be healed. So people, that's what Christ was speaking to people, to the disciples in parables, so that they would not understand. He used the popes, he used the pastors to shut the people's ears, to close their eyes and make their heart dull, so that they may see and not perceive, and hear and not understand, and don't have no love in their heart for their fellow man, but love for money and all kind of material stuff. Wow, people, don't y'all see? So that in these, in us, the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled. Jesus Christ. And then, hear the truth. Okay. Then I said that Isaiah chapter 6 verse 11. Then I said, Lord, how long? So Isaiah is asking God, how long shall I do this to the people? How long shall I make their ears shut and their eyes heavy and their hearts dull? How long? And God said, and he answered, until the cities are laid waste and without inhabitants, and the houses are without a man, and the land is utterly forsaken, desolated. Don't you hear that, people? Oh, wow. People, this Isaiah of the Bible, this Christ, in Isaiah chapter 6, who's Jesus Christ, he asked God. God said, who shall we send? And he sent me. And he said, close the eyes of these people, shut their ears, and make their heart dull, so that they may not perceive, they may not understand, they may not love. Because if they do that, they're going to turn back, and I'm going to have to heal them. And Isaiah said, Lord, how long should I do this to them? And he said, until the cities are desolated and without inhabitants, until the houses are without a man. Peter, what's going on until the land is utterly desolated? Peter, what's going on today? Look in the household. Where are the men? They're in the Middle East fighting wars. Are they dead? Are in prison? Are they vagabonds? Women out here, single women taking care of the kids. I'm not with my kid mom because we like water and fire and water. So, you know what I'm saying? And I understand that most men walk away. Most men walk away. I understand that. They're circumstances. But what I'm trying to say, the houses are without a man, and the cities are laid waste, and the land is utterly desolated. That's the prophecy of Isaiah that Christ came to fulfill. So Christians, read it. Okay? Read it again. Let me go back if I could find them. Mark 4, right? And in Matthew, wherever it is, and Isaiah chapter 6. Read them, people. This is what Christ came to do. But he wasn't even Christ. It's the popes and the pastors. Okay? These religious fanatics. They're the ones who did it. Okay? They know man up there come down and up the sky and did this. These are men on earth who's doing this. Okay, whether they play with aliens or not, these are men on earth doing it. Ain't no Jesus Christ coming out the sky to save you. Paul Merkel is here, and each one of you is here. We are the saviors. Okay, each one of us are our own Jesus Christ, personal responsibility. No man can pay for your dirty sin them. Okay, stop being a cop out and giving your sin to other people. Wow, you have the audacity to give to want the next man to die for your sin. What audacity you have. Wow, you're a couple weak. Come on, that's weakness. Okay, your sin, pay for it, man up. Okay, and stop believing in idiocy. Because guess what? Your own Bible have condemned you. Because Christ have stuffed up your ears. He have closed your eyes and make your heart dull. One love.